ladies and gentlemen, TGIF. Thank God it's Friday. It is Friday, the 24th of March in the year 2023. Say hi, Daniel. I'm saying hi.
Hi, Peter.
You could be saying hi to Daniel, actually. I could be. That was a blooper. We'll keep it in the content of the video for today. All right, ladies and gentlemen, we are going to a service call that Daniel went to on, I believe it was Monday. Yes, it was Monday. And Daniel installed a 3/4 inch RPZ. That is a reduced pressure zone. Sorry, we were rudely interrupted by the phone. So Daniel installed a backflow prevention device. Look, there's a Frankie's truck. Would have been Frankie's truck, right? The lone van right there. Frankie. Oh, that guy really has some nerve. That guy has some nerve. He actually called me yesterday at 4 o'clock in the morning. It was actually, that's where I was. But it was like 6:45 here or 7 o'clock here, New York time. Mm-hmm. Wanted to know where his check was. And I'm like, what are you, feffing retarded? Like, how about I should have charged you for the plane ticket and for the... This is annoying. There's one thing that I hate are annoying telemarketers. The guy actually called... I remember him. He called me on, I think it was Tuesday or Monday of this week. This guy on the map called my cell phone. And I said, listen, I don't know why you have my cell phone. Don't call me again. And that was him again. Because I called your office. They told me to call your cell phone. I was like, no, they didn't. Effing liar.
Irritating.
Anyway, we're outside Hewlett Auto Body over here in Woodmere, which is in New York, on Long Island in New York State. Wish this was Florida.
Yeah.
Land of DeSantis.
South Carolina.
Yeah, Hilton Head.
Tennessee,
yeah. Oh, you like Tennessee. Oh.
I like it a
lot. You find some nice Southern girls, Southern belles?
Everyone's nice, though.
Everyone's nice. See, no one's nice in New York.
No one's nice.
Nana Claire is nice, though.
She's nice. She's doing great.
Nana Claire, we love you. Okay. We're at the Hewlett Auto Body where Daniel installed a 3/4 inch reduced pressure zone. It's a containment device for protecting the water supply system. We're going to go there. We're going to test it. Let's go see. I think there's only one word appropriate for the work that Daniel did here.
I know exactly what word
that is. And you know what word that is? It starts with a T, it ends with an S, and it's 4 letters. I'm going to try to keep it family friendly. So it's T.
Spectacular.
Yeah, spectacular. Check this out. Well, look what Daniel did, by the way. And you did too. Look at that. You see this? Wow. That is very, very nice. Now, I understand why there's a rag in here, because the cold air from outside. And again, it is what it is. But look at this beautiful install. We have the split ring hangers. We have the anchors to the wall. Like, this is really, really, really nice. Really, really nice. Now, someone could comment, like, why don't you put a valve before and after it? You don't. This is called shut off valve number one. After we determine direction of flow. Which way is direction of flow?
This way.
Is it that way? Okay, so this is called shut off valve number one. This is called shut off valve number two. This is test port. Yes, correct. Test port 1, 2, 3, and 4. And this is the Wilkins. This is the 975 XL2. We have a vent here, or the discharge line, right? And that's in case we're in an auto body shop, right? I couldn't install a double check valve here because we have a high risk of contaminating the public water supply and the chemicals, things like that, which are like hazardous to your, you know, health. You know, if you want to die, then yeah, I guess it makes sense. But for like 50 years, which is the duration of time this auto body shop has been here, there's never been a containment device such as this installed. The water meter's in the ground right here, by the way. And Daniel cut into that and ran two lines and installed this. So now we're here to test it. Okay? So, let's open this back up. Okay? Oh, someone just used the water. See that? So let's take our watts. This is the TK9A. This thing's expensive. This thing is like $2,000. If you don't believe me,
I was wrong.
Yeah?
I'm way off. There it is. I'm way off. There you go. Between 1900, you know, that's definitely used.
Yeah.
That's actually a great price, though. You can always rebuild that. But look, there you go. 36. Yeah, they're not cheap.
Not at all. All
right. When I got this, it was about $1,200. That was a long time ago. All right, so we're going to test this. And in New York State, we have two different test procedures. Here is one for the reduced pressure zone test procedure using a three-valve pressure differential test kit, which is what that is. And we also have this one here, similar. This is also the same thing, but the steps are slightly different. Mm-hmm. We're going to use this one first, and we're going to go from there. So let's take out the stuff from our test kit. We're going to need one, two, and three test plugs, right? And we'll put a little Teflon on there, and we'll put on two, three, and four. Mm-hmm. All right.
Two, three, four.
So here's our valve. There's our Watts TK9A. Here's our instruction sheet. So Peter, number one, determine direction of flow. Okay. Number two, close shutoff valve number one. I'm sorry, number two. Right, and make sure there's no discharge from relief valve should be present. If there is any discharge from there, it's failed. Okay, that means that you have to, you know, go from there. We would blow off test cocks two, three, and four. It's a brand new device. I'm not doing that to eliminate any dirt or debris. We're gonna connect the high pressure hose to test cock number two. Okay. Now, we're gonna connect the low pressure hose to test cock number three. Okay. Now, we're gonna open test cocks two and three. But before we do that, I'm gonna press stop on the phone. No. By the way, okay, you got that. Let's close. Close. Okay, open that. Let's put our bypass hose into the drain. Okay. Now, we're gonna bleed open test cocks two and three. Okay. Now, we're gonna bleed the high pressure hose through control valves A and C on the test kit. All right, so let's open up A and C. Okay, that's A. Hey, shove it in there deep enough, it's not gonna go anywhere. Okay. You're gonna open up C. No, that's not C, that's B.
That's B.
Yeah. Okay, open. All right. Now you're gonna close A. Now you're gonna open up B and C.
This and this?
Yeah, B, open up B. Keep going, open up B. Okay. Get all the air out of there. Mm-hmm. Now close B and C. Okay, so after bleeding hoses record the line pressure, all right, we'll test that with a different device, and note pressure drop across first check valve. So, what do we have there?
We have nine.
We have nine. Okay, so now we're gonna test the relief valve. Okay, we're gonna open control valve A on test kit. Okay. And now we are going to slowly open control valve B. Now the relief valve, right, should open at 2 PSID or above, okay? And we're gonna make note of that, okay? So we're gonna open up B, and we're gonna make note of what the pressure is there when that starts to drip, okay? It has to be above two. So slowly open that, slowly, okay? There you go. So you're at two and a half.
Yeah.
Very good. Okay.
Close.
Yep. Okay. So that was 2.5. Now, if it doesn't, then there's a relief valve failure. Okay. So now we're going to test check valve number one.
Like this?
Yeah. Well, like, you know, right in front of it. So put your hand like that. Open that valve a little bit. We're going to reestablish pressure. This is close, 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 close. Good.
Open for?
Yep. Let's open a little bit. Okay, now close it. Good. Okay, so we reestablished pressure. We're back to that 9 PSID. Good. Okay, you ready? So we opened it. The needle should go back or close to the original pressure drop. If there is no discharge from a relief valve, check number one is holding. Okay, and it's good. If there's a discharge there, that means it's no good. Now, we're going to connect the bypass hose to test cock number four. We're almost done. Bypass hose, test cock number four. Okay. Now you're going to open test talk number 4. Okay. And you're going to open the control valves A and C on the kit. A is already open. C. Good. And if we have no discharge, check valve number 2 is good. So, right now we're done. We're going to close test cocks 2, 3, and 4, and then put the device back into service. See, we don't do that many of these testing ones, but this is actually a pleasure to actually test. Because, see, since we installed it, mm-hmm. we're going to install it in a fashion that it could be serviced, yeah. right? Imagine if it was in the floor. Some monkey would have done that, right? Seriously. Yeah. It was in the floor, right? And trust me, it's there. Look. Look at the floor, and there's the cutaway for it right there. See? Right there. That's where the meter is, right below there. Some knucklehead would have put it there. Or made it in an unserviceable fashion, and you can never service it. And then every time someone comes here is gonna curse and yell and scream at the guy. Yeah. Like at the bagel place with the cockroaches all over in Valley Stream. Oh, it's yeah. under the table, like behind like infested freaking table. It's crazy. This is very nice. I'm sitting on the toilet. Well, I was. And there you are. Okay? No homo.